So you've had a little taste of multiplication by now, but how do you deal with multiplication with sine numbers? I'm Jimmy, and that's exactly what we're going to address today. I'm going to give you a few scenarios on how to multiply with the different kinds of sine numbers, and there's a couple of pointers that we'll be going over, so here we go. Now, the most straightforward aspect is if you have a positive number times a positive number. We're going to use 4 times 7 as an example. Now, 4 times 7 is obviously 28, so basically, the first scenario is done. It's very important that you know your times tables here because that's what we're really relying on. In fact, if the two numbers have the same sign, it's always going to be positive. Positive times positive is going to give you a positive number. But if you have a negative times a negative, that's going to give you a positive because the negative signs cancel each other out. So whenever you have two numbers multiplied together that have the same sign, your end result is always going to be positive. So negative 3 times negative 10, negative times a negative is going to give you a positive, so you just have to figure out what 3 times 10 is going to be, which is going to be 30. Now, if you have numbers of unlike signs multiplied with each other, it will always be negative. First, let's talk about positive 5 times negative 3. Because you have a positive times a negative, the signs are different. You know it's going to be negative. The only thing you have to keep in mind, of course, is what 5 times 3 is, which is going to be 15. The same thing happens if you have a negative number times a positive number. Well, negative times a positive is going to give you a negative number. You just have to figure out what 2 times 11 is going to be, which, after some thought, is going to give you 22. So negative 2 times 11 is negative 22. So I'm Jimmy, and I hope you have some ideas now on how to multiply signed numbers.